Now we are going to learn the proof, so clear, for laws of refraction using Huygens principle. Already we have learnt the proof for laws of reflection, which was proved with the help of the Huygens principle. Now we are going to learn the proof for the laws of refraction using Huygens principle. Here, look at the diagram. So in this diagram, two mediums are drawn. Just above the denser medium, rarer medium is there. The rarer medium refractive index is n1. When light travels through the rarer medium, its velocity can be taken as v1. And the rarer medium, its number is 1. First zwickel medium, that's why the number 1 is assigned. Just below to the rarer medium, one more medium is there. That is called denser medium. To cause the refraction, two mediums are required. Light, it has to travel from one medium to another medium, only then the light ray, it will get bent, okay, when it travels from one medium to another medium. That's why two medium are taken here. The second medium is a denser medium, its refractive index is n2. There, when light travels, the velocity of the light will be v2. So here, as per the wave theory, what the theory says now, the velocity of the light in the rarer medium is greater than that of the velocity of the light in the denser medium. Therefore, here the velocity of the light is greater, here the velocity of light is lesser. Now we are going to draw the ray diagram for the refraction of light, and with the help of wavefront concept, we are going to prove the laws of refraction. Okay, so first I will draw the incident ray. The incident ray, first incident ray I am going to draw by using a red color line. So this is the first incident ray, that is named as LA, and the direction of the ray is also mentioned. Very clear. As soon as the ray is drawn, as I have told earlier, we have to draw the normal. Very clear. This is the normal drawn here. Here you will get the angle of incidence I. Very clear. Now, after after incidence, what will happen? You know very well that this light ray, it gets refracted. Very clear. Instead of traveling in the straight line, the ray, it gets bent. Are you clear? So I am going to draw the refracted beam. So this is the refracted beam of light. Its name is named as, it is named as A here. It should be named as L dash. Therefore, this is incident ray, this is the refracted ray. Now I am going to draw another parallel ray for LA. So first you have to keep the scale like this. Slowly you move the scale parallel to the LA. Is it clear? In the inclined position, we have to draw the another ray. Okay, parallel ray. I am going to draw the another parallel ray. The name of the ray is called as MB dash. MB dash. MB dash is the another incident ray. Are you clear? Again, you know very well that what will happen here, we have to draw the normal for this another ray also. This is the normal. So after getting refraction, this ray also gets bent. Is it clear? So this one also must be parallel to this ray. So I have drawn the refracted ray for the second beam of light also. Are you clear? So this name of the ray must be named as BM dash. Are you clear? So here you are getting one angle here. This angle is called angle of refraction R. Like that, here also we are able to draw the angle of refraction R. Are you clear? Now, two mediums are there. Here, now we are going to draw the wavefront for the incident ray. Is it clear? Already I have explained how to draw the wavefront for the incident ray. Here, when the two rays, when they are traveling, the wavefront that should be drawn perpendicular to the rays. Let us imagine these are all the plane wavefront which are drawn for the parallel rays. So wavefront 1, wavefront 2, wavefront 3, wavefront 4, like this, for each point we can draw. When the ray touches the surface, this is the wavefront which is drawn for incident ray. Therefore, this wavefront is called as incident wavefront. So the plane wavefront which is drawn for incident ray is called as incident plane wavefront. That one will be perpendicular to the rays. Therefore, plane wavefront must be drawn for parallel rays. This is the wavefront drawn for incident ray. Therefore, this is to be called as incident plane wavefront. Are you clear? Here I have shown the two three-dimensional model of the wavefront. Now I am going to draw the line for showing the wavefront by drawing a green color line. So I have to draw a perpendicular line. For showing the wavefront. So the green line that shows the wavefront for incident rays. This is called incident wavefront. Make a note. Now this is called as incident wavefront. Here that angle I is there, no? Here the same I you will get here. Are you clear? The same I you will get. Here this wavefront can be named as AB. AB is called incident wavefront. Are you clear? Now here to get this I, how will you get this? Tell me. Is it clear? From the diagram, which one is I? I is equal to NAL is the formula. NAL. I is equivalent to NAL. Angle NAL that gives you I. Are you clear? That is equal to. How it can be written? Look at that. Are you able to see that? I is equal to angle NAL. Again, I will repeat. I is equal to, clear? NAL is the angle. That one gives you I. Are you clear? So here, the total angle is 90. Are you clear? So here, the 90, if it is subtracted from, is it clear? NAB is there, no? Is it clear? Total angle is 90. The total angle 90 minus NAB that gives you NAB. That also gives you which one? I. Make a note. Are you clear? So 90 minus NAB is equal to I. That is also equal to I. But this I is equal to, look at that. That I can be obtained from BAB dash. So BAB dash is also equal to I. So I is equal to NAL. Is it clear? This 90 degree totally here perpendicular is there. 90 minus NAB that gives you I. This I again it can be named as BAB dash. So like that we can write for I. So here incident wavefront is there. Are you clear? Now we are going to see one important thing. Look at that. Here, when the first ray touches here, when the first ray L, it touches the, reaches the point A, the second ray travels from M to B. When L reaches A, the ray M will reach from, is it clear? It starts its journey from M and reaches B. Are you clear? When L reaches A, M will reach B. When L touches here, what will happen? Is it clear? By the time still it has to travel further in rarer medium. Are you clear? So the ray it will travel from B to B dash. Is it clear? When the ray travels from B to B dash, where this one will go? That is the question here. Are you clear? Where this ray will go? That ray it will travel through the denser medium. Are you clear? My question is, whether this one travel from B to B dash, whether the same distance B, B dash will be traveled here. It is not so, because the velocity of the light in the denser medium is lesser. Are you clear? To travel this distance B, B dash, it will take some time T. Are you clear? It will take some time T. Make a note. I will write it here. To travel the distance B, B dash, it will take some time T. During this time T, it won't travel the same distance here. It will be traveling lesser distance because here the velocity of light is lesser. So I am marking a point here. Are you clear? That point can be named as, what is this? A. That point can be named as A. Is it clear? A dash. Are you clear? A dash. So the time taken to travel B, B dash and the time taken to travel A dash will be same. Here it travels longer distance, here it travels lesser distance, but the time taken to travel B, B dash and the time taken to travel A dash will be same. Here velocity is more, here velocity is less. Distance traveled is more, here distance traveled is less. But to travel A dash, to travel B, B dash, it takes the same time. Make a note. Now here we have to draw the clear wavefront for the refracted rays. These two are the refracted rays. For these two refracted rays, I have to draw the wavefront. How will you draw? We have to draw a perpendicular line from here. From here I have to draw the perpendicular line. Look at that. I am drawing a perpendicular line that is drawn with the help of green line. This is called as incident wavefront. This is called as refracted wavefront. Because this refracted wavefront is drawn for these two refracted waves. Are you clear? Now here you are able to see one perpendicular angle. Here also you can see one perpendicular angle. Here also 90 is there, here also 90 is there. Are you clear? Time taken to travel B, B dash, and the time taken to travel A, A dash will be same. Make a note. Are you clear? Now I'll write the exactly velocity formula here in the first medium. Only then we are able to understand. Are you clear? Here to travel clear in this distance, how will you write the velocity formula? V1 is equal to travel B, B dash, that is called distance travel, no, B, B dash, it will take some time T. Are you clear? To travel the distance A, A dash, clear, it will take the same time. Therefore, to calculate the velocity here, how will you calculate? V2 is equal to, how will you calculate? The distance traveled is A, A dash, and the time taken is T. What is the similarity in both the two equation? Distance traveled is different, velocity is different, but the time taken is same. Time taken is same. So how will you write the common equation for both the two? Now we can write T is equal to B B dash divided by V1 can be written. Are you clear? Like this we can write T is equal to A A dash divided by V2 can be written. These two time takens are same. Make a note. To travel from here to there, to travel from A to A dash, both are same time. Is it clear? To travel from here to there, to travel to A from A, A dash, is it clear? It takes same time. Therefore, these two equations can be equated like this. T is equal to B, B dash divided by V1 is equal to A, A dash divided by V2. So in this format, we can write. Why these two can be equated? Because time taken to travel from B, B dash and A, A dash both are similar. Make a note. Are you clear? Because here velocity is more, here velocity is less. So the most important thing is V1 is greater than V2. So that important thing must be known clearly here. Are you clear? Now we are going to measure the angle of refraction. Where the angle of refraction is? Here R is there. This R is measured with the help of the ray. Here where, how can we measure the R? Where the R will be? That is a question here. Here R is there, no? The same R that could be obtained here. The same R that could be, alternate angles are equal. So here, if the R angle of refraction is measured here, means this one will be equivalent to this one. Now how will you write R here? Is it clear? So here how to write R? Already we have write angle for I, no? Like this we have to write the angle R also. How will you write? With the help of rays. Is it clear? First we have to write R is equal to, here we can name the ray N dash. Here this is B dash, this is M dash. So the R is equal to, we can write N dash, B dash and M dash. So in between these two, some angle is there, no? That is called angle of refraction. That is equal to, now with the help of the triangle we have to write. The total angle will be 90. Are you clear? The total angle will be 90. There you can write 90 minus. The total angle is 90, no? So clear, 90, that is to be subtracted by this angle. Are you clear? So will you write 90 minus triangle N dash, B dash, A. Is it clear? N dash, B dash, A is the angle here. Are you clear? If this angle is subtracted, you will get this angle. Are you clear? 90 minus N dash, B dash, A must be written. Are you clear? Only then you will get this angle. For this particular angle also, some name should be assigned. How will you assign the name for R? Look at that. Basically, how will you write? A dash, B dash, A must be written. Basically, A dash, B dash, A must be written. This is the appropriate name for the angle R. So like that we can assign the name. Okay. Now is it clear? Now here here two right angle triangles are there. This is the first right angle triangle, this is the another right angle triangle. Now we have to prove the laws of refraction. What laws of refraction says? Laws of refraction says that incident ray, look at that incident ray and then refracted ray and the normal. Incident ray, refracted ray and the normal. All the three lie on the exactly same plane. Where is the plane? That plane is nothing but clear. That plane is nothing but clear. The mirror. Mirror is the sorry. That surface is no. That surface of separation is here. This is called surface of the separation. In between the rarer medium and denser medium, here one separation is there. That is called surface of separation. That one also can be taken as a plane. And then is it clear? This paper can also be taken as a plane. Are you clear? Incident ray, refracted ray, and the normal. All the three they lie on the same plane. Means is it clear? The surface of separation on which all the three they lie. Okay, they are not separated. So that is the first proof. Now, the most important thing is now we are going to prove the Snell's law also. We are going to prove the Snell's law. Already you have learned Snell's law. That is sin I by sin r. Sin of angle of incidence to the sin of angle of refraction. That gives you the constant called refractive index. That one also to be proved here. Are you clear? Now we are going to get the expression for sin I and sin r. Are you clear? How to get sin I? How to get sin r? From the first right angle triangle, we are able to get the sin I. First is with the help of the second right angle triangle, we are able to get the next triangle sin r. So with the help of the first triangle is which one? Is it clear? Which one is the first triangle? Angle A dash, A dash, and then B, B dash. Where is it? Tell me. First angle is, you write like this, A, B, B dash, A, B, B dash. This is the first triangle. From this we are able to write, is it clear, sin I. Now I am going to write the expression for sin I. How will you write the expression for sin I? Tell me, is it clear, which one is opposite here? This is called opposite. Are you clear? Now we can write it as B, B dash is the opposite. And which one is the opposite divided by hypotenuse? Which one is hypotenuse? That A, B dash is the clear hypotenuse. A, B dash is the hypotenuse. Sin I is equal to opposite divided by hypotenuse. Are you clear? So like that we can write sin I. From this triangle, second triangle, from the second triangle, what is the name of the second triangle? A, and then look at here. We are able to get the sin r value from the second triangle. Sin r is equal to, from this triangle we are able to get the sin r, opposite divided by hypotenuse. Opposite is a, a dash. Hypotenuse is a, b dash. So a, a dash divided by a, b dash, that gives you sin r. Are you clear? Now from Snell's law, we have to prove the Snell's law. That is the second law of refraction. Sin I by sin r to be calculated. Sin I expression is known. Sin I expression is b, b dash divided by a, b dash. Sin r expression is a, a dash divided by a, b dash. Here the numerator b, b dash is there, a, a dash is there. The denominator a, b dash is there. Both are common factors. So therefore we can strike out both the two. After that you are getting b, b dash divided by a dash. Okay, already from this expression we are able to get the expression for b, b dash. B, b dash is equal to b1t. A, a dash is equal to b2t. Substitute a, a dash, b, b dash in this equation. B, b dash is equal to v1t divided by v2t. Tt can be cancelled. Finally, you are getting v1 divided by v2. Therefore, I will write the expression here. Sin I divided by sin r is equal to, this expression must be written. What is this? V1 divided by V2 can be written. Are you clear? This one can be written in some other form. Are you clear? Look at that. Just for mathematical convenience, I am writing like this. C divided by V2 whole divided by सी डिवाइडेड बाय वी टू डिवाइडेड बाय सी डिवाइडेड बाय वी वन. सो इन दिस फॉर्मेट दिस वन कैन बी रिटन. इफ दिस वन इज ऑल्टर्ड यू विल गेट दिस वन. मेक ए नोट. आर यू क्लियर? नाउ दिस एक्सप्रेशन sin I by sin R, again that must be written, which is equal to, look at the expression which is written at the top. If the speed of the light in vacuum, if it is divided by the speed of the light in the medium, you will get a constant. That constant is nothing but refractive index of the medium. Again you will say, speed of the light in vacuum to the speed of the light in the medium, that one will be the constant. That constant is nothing but refractive index of the medium. Are you clear? By using this expression, same expression is there in the numerator and denominator. C divided by V2. Same expression, 2 is there. Therefore, that one gives you the refractive index of the second medium. Divided by C divided by V2, that gives you N2. What is N2? Refractive index of the second medium. C divided by V1, that gives you the refractive index of the first medium. Are you clear? So from this expression N2 you will get, from this expression you will get N1. Are you clear? So this is in ratio form. The same thing that can be written in product form also. How will you write the value in product form? I'll write it in product form. Cross multiply this. After cross multiplication you will get N1 sin I will be equal to N2 sin R. In this format you will get the Snell's law. So here we have proved the Snell's law also. We have proved the Snell's law. Are you clear? So this is also Snell's law formula. This is also Snell's law formula. This is in ratio form. This is in product form. Make a note. Are you clear? So here the most important thing is, when light ray travels from one medium to another medium, ratio, that can be given in terms of refractive index. Are you clear? N2 divided by N1, that gives you sin I by sin R. This is one of the important formula. This formula is often used everywhere. Are you clear? Now, clear? We can write the same formula in various forms. Okay. So in this complete derivation, we have proved two laws of refraction. One is the incident ray and the refracted ray normal. These three lie on the same plane. Like that, the incident wavefront and the refracted wavefront both also lie on the same plane. So here, which one is the incident wavefront? This is the incident wavefront. This is the refracted wavefront. Make a note. This is the wavefront drawn for incident ray. This is the wavefront drawn for refracted ray. Don't forget. So here Snell's law is also proved. The Snell's law that is derived with the help of the expression. Okay.